In this video, I will demonstrate how to install Mailu on Docker as a complete mail service tech solution in less than 20 minutes. The requirements for a Mailu server are a public IPv4 address, a domain name with DNS server management access, at least 2 GB of RAM if you want to run with ClamAV, any modern Linux distribution where you have root access to install and control Docker. Okay, so let's get started. I will put the stopwatch, just a moment, to show the actual time that we took to install a Ubuntu server from scratch with 4 GB of RAM. We will install Docker on it and then Mailu. And this is all we need to get a mail server going. So here I'm just adding the IP address to my DNS records. We are using mail.moolhammer.com as a host name. See if we can SSH into the server now. Yes. All right. First thing we do is a update of all the packages on the server to prevent any future conflicts and to be sure that we have our security up to date. So now we just need to follow the Docker documentation on how to install the Docker engine for community on Ubuntu. This documentation it's really all the steps we need. So I'm just gonna copy paste it. I've tested all this before. Update, we've done it. This installs some packages that we need to add the repository of Docker. Let's check if we added the correct key of the Docker repository. Seems to be correct. This adds the repository. And now we update the package list. And finally, we get to install Docker. Now I've done this on other distributions as well, like Debian and Fedora. And basically the steps here in the Docker documentation are complete and functional. So it's pretty easy to pull in Docker nowadays, which makes it also easier to get Mailu on any server. So Docker is installed. 19.03, which is the current version. Now the next thing that we need is a recent version of Docker Compose. Docker Compose that comes with Ubuntu is outdated, and we've had users with several problems with that, so we are just gonna pull it here using curl. You can also install it using pip, but then you first have to install pip because it's not on Ubuntu servers by default. Okay, so this is the most up-to-date version and it's functional. So now that we have Docker and Docker Compose, we need a Docker Compose file. which we get from setup.melu.io. StoragePad tells us where all the mail files and databases are going to be stored. This is our mail domain, moolhammer.com. The postmaster address, so admin@moolhammer.com, we use Let's Encrypt to obtain TLS certificates. I always like this value a little bit higher. We will not submit statistics to the Mailu statistics server for this demonstration. We will enable the admin UI. If you don't enable this, you still have a command line to configure Mailu. We will enable Roundcube Webmail, my personal favorite, antivirus, WebDAV, and FetchMail. I will do another video to show you exactly how all that works. Here we need the public IP address of the server. Yeah. Which is this one. So we just smash it in there. We will not enable IPv6 for now because it's a bit too complicated. Then the host name of the server, which will be used for the TLS certificate. SQLite is fine for most small deployments. Okay, so our configuration was generated. This tells us that we have to create the storage directory on the server, cd into it, and then download the Docker Compose and Mailu AMV that was generated for us. Okay, step two, review the configuration. Use any editor you like. So this will pull in Redis, which is used as a memory store for authentication limiting. These are the ports where the front container, the NGX reverse proxy, will listen on. This is the only service that needs public ports. The rest doesn't need them. The unbound resolver, admin service, IMAP, Dovecot, SMTP from Postfix, anti-spam server, RSpamD, antivirus, ClamAV, WebDAV, Radical, and FetchMail, and a webmail from Roundcube. And this is the internal network configuration. Internal meaning between containers. Then we have to check mailu.env. This secret key is randomly generated by the setup server. It is, however, recommended to always change it to be on the safe side and sleep well at night knowing that nobody could have interfered. This secret key is used to sign all your authentication cookies. Alright, so this is everything that setup did for us. Let's encrypt authentication, rate limits, admin panel, webmail, radical, all good. No strange things in here. Password encryption scheme and the DB flavor. So that's all good. Now we can just run docker compose up -d. -d will demonize the containers after they're up. If we won't do that, then we hit Ctrl C at one point and all the containers are stopped, which is something we definitely don't want. So this will take some time. Meanwhile, I'm gonna set the reverse DNS on the server, in this case a virtual machine. Now most anti-spam filters require the reverse DNS to be in the same domain or even the same as the host name as the SMTP server. So our SMTP server is going to be at mail.moolhammer.com, which is practically the host name we've set here also. Right, so this is the forward DNS entry for this IP address. heel dat moeilijk hebben, dat come resolves to this IP address. And here the IP address reversely resolves to mail.moolammer.com. So this would help us pass spam filters for our mail. Okay, so the containers are up and running. The first thing that I always want to check is the logs on the front container. NGX that is trying to obtain the certificates, which worked. How is it your certificate and chain has been saved at blah blah blah. So now the reverse proxy is up and running using TLS. This basically tells us that the ACME server was capable of parsing our DNS records and getting the challenge to go. So this command here will create our primary admin user. I will just set a simple password first. Created admin user. So now we can go to mail.moolammer.com/admin. And here we just put our first admin user with simple. And the first thing that we need to do is change the password for something less simple. Okay, so we can go to mail domains, and here we find our moolammer.com domain, and this tells us how we have to configure the DNS. Now I believe that this is bind specific configuration. I don't use bind, I have a web UI for my provider, so I will just copy paste the parts that I need. And let's get this out of the way. So our MX record will point to mail.moolammer.com. Have to add a priority. Okay. Then SPF, which basically tells the receiving server who is allowed to send on our behalf, like which hosts are allowed to send on our behalf. So that's our MX host. Whatever is connected to the A record, and minus all means that nobody else is allowed to send mail on our behalf. And the next thing we need is the DACIM signing key. This is a public key. The server holds the private key, and every outgoing mail is signed by this private key, and then receiving servers check it using this public key. If there is a mismatch on it, then they know that the mail didn't come from us and it should be dropped. DMARC record basically tells the other servers where to contact us in case things are not okay. If somebody is sending spam from our domain, from malicious servers, and that kind of stuff, then we will receive reports here on admin@moolammer.com. Also set some parameters we're using Dakim and that sorts of stuff. So we are going to change, save this. So now everything is set. This means that it's fully configured. What we can do now is going to the webmail. Again, we will add our user here. I will just send an email to my other testing server. And this will test local delivery as well. That was local delivery and remote delivery. So the mail server works. We can also edit that. Now here we have to modify the username to include the domain, because our service Mailu is a multi-domain server, so it needs to know the whole email address to can authenticate users. So here we can see the email earlier, the local delivery email, and here we can try to reply, see if the mail server can also receive. So this is my other testing server. Yes. So this also demonstrates that our server can receive mail over SMTP. That's a mail server running in little less than 20 minutes. The only thing that remains is to check on a tool like MX Toolbox if we have set up everything correctly. So one error on HTTP, because we are not running a website on moolammer.com, we just have a mail server. The most important part is that we are not an open relay, we support TLS, and the reverse DNS records look okay. So this was setting up Mailu in a nutshell. Please refer to the documentation for more information and configuration options. You can find us on GitHub. You can raise issues, open pull requests, sponsor us, and give us a star if you want. Thank you for watching this video.